This is major infrastructure that we're making happen.
2,500 dedicated, detailed, professional people working on the project.
It's very rewarding to work on cutting-edge projects like this that are leading the charge in the transition to renewable energy.
What really gets me excited about wind energy is that it really is the future. This isn't something that we have to transition away from. This is what we're transitioning to.
I mean, this is such a rural community. Work is hard to find, good work even harder. And, you know, the income that a guy or a lady can make coming out here to be a tech or working on the power side of this stuff or environmental, there's so many opportunities. Never thought that this would be something that was happening in my own backyard. The fact that I get to be involved and the level I get to be involved in it at, it's gonna be really cool, I think, 30 years down the road when grandkids are running around, I'll be able to tell them that, yeah, Grandpa was part of it.
SunZia is going to be one of the staple projects in the history of the United States. This has got 674 different 154 machines that are going into ground.
It's staggering just to even think about the scale of SunZia, larger than the landmass of Rhode Island. It's just unbelievable. This is next level.
It's very cool to be a part of the SunZia project. I mean, you know, family, friends, they know about renewables, they know about wind. It's pretty common knowledge, but a lot of people don't understand the detail of it. And you give that initial, oh, you know, I build wind turbines, and people, oh, that's neat. They're interested. And okay, where are you working now? Well, I'm down in New Mexico. How big is the project you're building? Well, you know, over 3,000 megawatts. It's the biggest renewable energy infrastructure project ever constructed in North America, and the jaws kind of drop.
Yeah, so it's really been the culmination of many years of work, starting really with Pattern in this SunZia project more than 5 years ago, trying to decide what would be the best type of product for the large project that they were putting in. So it's 3.6 megawatts and 154 meter rotor diameter, which makes it the most efficient, highest capacity factor unit in the US. What that means is that for every megawatt of interconnect, this product will put more kilowatt hours, more electrons on the grid than any other product out there.
We've designed this product specifically to be a winning product in the United States. Part of that, right, is our supply chain and our partners in the U.S., our customers, but also the manufacturing facility that we're in here in Pensacola. This is a 100-plus-year-old building. We've been producing wind turbine nacelles here since wind started in the United States market. There is a proud legacy here at Pensacola.
The employees are really proud of this new product, this MPI. They work really hard on it.
I keep using the word exciting. It's just to know that our plant in Pensacola, Florida, we'd be forever known as the flagship of this amazing project.
Over, I would say, the last 20 years, we've really lost expertise within the U.S. when it comes to manufacturing. So to be able to see us growing, renovating, and investing in this manufacturing facility is like a true sign that we're really supporting that manufacturing foundation and uplifting it.
We knew that was going to be a quick ramp up. You never really know how quick the ramp up is going to be, though. It was quick. It was like one day, nothing, and the next day we were building units, and then the next week we're building three units, and the next day we're building five units.
So when you do these things at scale like this, number one, you have the opportunity to be really, really good at it, right? So you're doing the same thing you do every week, and you just repeat, repeat, repeat. So we should get high quality out of it. We should get cost savings out of it. We should get efficiencies out of it. And honestly, if we're going to decarbonize the U.S. at that pace of 5x, the only way you do it is around projects of this size and scale.
Our team has moved mountains in the past, the last 23 years. Every time we have one, we meet the challenge, and just really proud of the team.
I will give you a corny saying, but I still like it. If you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. So that's really where like the teamwork comes into play.
I have a one-year-old daughter, and I think about what am I going to tell her as she starts to understand what my job is.
So this is probably the most impactful place to be working as an engineer to do something about the climate crisis.
The prototype is one piece of our validation scheme that we look at when we approach the design.
It's a bit surreal because your head is so deep in the details until, you know, we finally built this prototype, we have something real to look at.
And given the scale of the installation of SunZia, the installation of this prototype was critical of knowing, can we install this safely with quality, but then at scale, right? And so that was a really big milestone that we hit here at the prototype site, was that we can do that, that we feel comfortable, and that we're gonna proceed to installs of 674 of these in a matter of a year and a half.
This whole development process takes years. And so once it finally comes together, once it's finally a real thing, once it's actually producing power as it now is with the prototype, it kind of puts things into perspective. I mean, it's kind of looking like looking up at the stars and just knowing your place in the universe. It's so much bigger than any one person.
A lot of people don't even realize that every state that we travel through to get to the customer site could have a slightly different laws on the size, the width, the height, how many escorts for a certain type of load and which routes. So we really rely on our hand-picked and qualified carriers to bring their expertise to the table. We knew that the back axles swell up, and so we had them design the nacelle to come up and step so that back end hangs over the axles and doesn't actually sit in the well of the trailer. So that's like a unique feature that was specifically designed for transportability. Don't forget about logistics. You can't just get it out the factory door. You have to get it all the way to site in good condition.
You know, from a New Mexico perspective, one of the unique things about this project, as I mentioned, is the requirement for efficiency. But it's also a very hot environment and a very high altitude environment, which means low density, high temperature. So we need a turbine, including an electrical system, that can max out that efficiency through all of those operating conditions.
This turbine has all of our special sauce. It has a little bit from almost every single platform that we've ever created. From almost every single component, we've really tried to leverage what we've learned in the past and make a collective decision of what is going to be the most robust design that can scale up to a site like SunZia, and also, you know, hopefully future mega projects that are similar.
Being able to maintain the schedule of installing and erecting the turbines, I just think it's a good example of how multiple organizations come together for a common goal, especially of this magnitude.
Our customers, our services teams, we're all in this together.
We need each other, right? They've got to put the turbines in the ground, they got to set up the project, and they need our technology to work as expected. We're going to give them all the information they need to be successful, and we're going to do our best to deliver the highest quality product that's ever been launched.
SunZia is going to be one of the largest power plants in the United States, not just wind farms. It's going to power literally several million people over the Southwest United States into California. I mean, that level of impact for a team bringing a vision to reality is just, it's an amazing thing to be a part of.
From design to manufacture to transportation, installation, and operation over the life cycle of a wind turbine and a wind farm, really been focusing on how do we ensure great quality from a design perspective, and then for each step of the life cycle going forward.
If anyone's gonna do it, it's us, right? We're up for the challenge.
They're excited about the direction that GE Vernova is taking us. They're excited to be a part of a company that is in the forefront of renewable energy.
The ambition of SunZia may be the most unique thing when you think about coupling it in one site that's going to have 3.5 gigawatts. You know, just the ambition of doing that, just not a scale you see every day.